Okay, we will see cursor adapter. I mean, additional adapter, like, you know, so far we have seen array adapter and simple adapter. Now what we are going to see is simple cursor adapter. It's same thing, not require, most of the part I can simply use it. The benefit of using a cursor adapter is if you have an active database connection, if you could retrieve the cursor, that cursor can be directly attached to an adapter and then have your layout inflation time. For example, the last, the code where we used a simple adapter, yes. So in this example, the simple adapter takes the array list of hash map. So we had to convert the entire cursor into array list of hash map, then add it to a simple adapter to get our list view with the data. A simple cursor adapter removes this difficulty. It doesn't require a specific mapping data like array list of hash map. The cursor itself can be directly sent as an argument instead of this array list, and then it can directly populate into a list view. But conditions apply. One, the database connection should be open throughout. It cannot be closed. At least the cursor should not be closed, because the cursor maintains every occurrence of the retrieval of a database require a connection with the database. So it is better to keep a single instance of a database open or connection and close the database when you destroy your application. For example, when the application is no more, we can close the database. Second requirement, the primary key of your database. Let me see what's the primary key I gave. The primary key of your database should always be in underscore ID. If you change it to different thing, it won't work. That's the reason the very beginning I kept it as a, otherwise I would have given the primary key as a student ID, something I would have given. But I purposefully kept it because next I will use a cursor adapter. So simple cursor adapter require active database connection, and the primary key of your database should have underscore ID. Otherwise, you cannot use a simple cursor adapter. The benefit of simple cursor adapter is I can directly display the content retrieved from the database. Nothing but the object type cursor can be directly pointed to an adapter, and we can have the view, rendered in the list view. I don't need a hash map or something else. So I'm going to do a little touch up in this code. So it's already my underscore ID, so I don't need to do much changes. So this is where I'm displaying the simplest activity. This is where I'm using simple cursor adapter. I'm going to do a few changes. I'm not going to close the connection, I'm going to keep the connection open. Okay, that will give you a memory leak because it's a local object. Okay, first we'll achieve our requirement, then think about this memory leak. Instead of simple adapter, let me comment for a while. Keep everything. So comment. Okay, we have a cursor now. I'm not going to create the array list anymore, because remember this I can safely comment as well. So not this one. This is commenting all the code so that these things are not going to be Okay, I'll come in for a while, then I'll activate them for edit and delete. So now I got rid of the array list of hash map. Now deploy our simple cursor adapter. Keep it at the end. It is simple cursor adapter. Initialize. It takes two overrided methods or set of arguments. One being deprecated seems to be, but the later one was added in API level 11 alone. So I'm just going to go ahead with the first one. The first argument being context, second being the layout. What is the layout we are using? Third, this guy is not showing suggestion. Okay, let's try. Cursor. And of course the mappings, the same set of mappings. It will show you a kind of, it's all deprecated methods mean this particular method no more in use. The last updated method right now is just need to add a flag, but we'll come back to it. What is that last argument a little later? But since your emulators are running into a lower version, you are using the emulator running in 8, so a couple of people, so in that case it won't throw an error. Okay, the mapping has to be slightly different. This key should be from the database, not from the key what you have defined for the ArrayList of hash map, because these keys we used in ArrayList of hash map should be database specific. Because the cursor will have this key. You are not going to display the ID, primary key, but anyway, the cursor will still have a reference to it. List set. So now we are pointing the cursor directly to a adapter and it is going to populate the list. Okay, I need to check, then do some sort of debugging. Remember, I haven't closed my database, I haven't closed my cursor, still it is open. Let me see what kind of problem I'm going to see. I get my list view as usual, but this time it is actually through the simple cursor adapter. Add is not going to work. Add should work. Okay, let me try to add something. Yes. So the data is right now without an intermediate one called ArrayList of hash map. The data is directly pointed using simple cursor adapter. This kind of adapter would be useful if you are retrieving a cursor from a database. It means wherever you use SQLite, you can use it. Otherwise, you cannot use this. Let me try to do some sort of fixes. Let me try to close the cursor. Close the database. If any error comes, we'll decide accordingly. something, the data is not there. Because obvious reason, it has lost the connection with the database. And adapter could not fetch the data. Is there any trace I could get? So, let me see. Maybe you don't see anything. Here. This is something acquired long back, 1132. Sorry, this is something different. Okay, I don't see substantial information. Okay, let me just comment this block. I'm not going to close the cursor, but still close the database. Let me try. Oh, it works. So, I'm not closing the cursor connection, but I close the connection only after adding the adapter, not before. Oh, sorry, this clip won't work. That's so the requirement being an active database connection needed. And that database connection can be closed after consuming the cursor, but still the cursor would require connection with the database. That's why I'm not closing the cursor for some time. But that also may trigger some sort of issues, maybe. Let me see, because why the cursor need an active connection? Maybe when the user trying to retrieve some values, for example, in this case the primary key is hidden. To edit or delete, I need to get the ID of this record. So in that case, if any error comes, we have to identify. Now, I've commented certain part. Now I'm trying to edit it. Edit, since I'm commented, let me put it back. To retrieve the data of your particular list item, I need to get the primary key. Previously, I could get the primary key by iterating over the array list and get the ID, which has got mapped. In this case, there is no such data, so I need to depend on the cursor directly. That can be accessed this way directly, because the cursor knows the ID, primary key. That's why we kept the primary key always underscore ID. We're trying to access ID, it will search for a primary key having a column name underscore ID. It will fetch the specific record and send it for editing. Similarly, this one. Let me see how things goes on. Okay. So this time I want to make sure whether I'm getting the right data. Let's go edit. Getting it. Trying to modify. It changes. Okay, time. Let me try to delete. Does. So with some sort of easiness, we simply migrated to a new adapter type. Now I'm not going to need this kind of a special hash map set. If I'm using a database, I can very well get rid of this map array list of hash map. I'm not going to need it. I I think a couple of keys also I can remove. So anywhere I'm using them. Okay, clear, clear. Let it tell it is being used. Student name directly being used. So I think I can get rid of these two as well. If I'm not using, well, let me save. Somewhere it's been used, me it will throw an error. So code has become much cleaner now. We don't need an in-between data type, which is going to be useful to create a hash map and attach to an adapter. But this time we have a simple cursor adapter which can directly display the database element. Only condition, the cursor should not have a close connection. If you have the cursor closed, the simple adapter cannot fetch the item. By opening the cursor, it need to get the individual item, so the cursor will need some sort of connection with the database. Cursor close will make sure the cursor is fully consumed and the connection can be closed, but the simple adapter keep consuming the cursor for some time, even for retrieving the data whenever required. Let me have it closed. Is there any effect happens? Let me identify. In fact, the data itself won't load, I remember. We just tested. Data is not populated because it has to fetch the individual item from the cursor, so it may need a connection to the database. So just connecting that. Okay. So this is an example of simple cursor adapter. Let me explain one more adapter after this. That is our own customized adapter. Probably I'll write a simple another example rather than populating in this example. And again, okay, so this is for a simple cursor adapter. If you are using SQLite, make sure you use simple cursor adapter. And this kind of thing also very important. You need to migrate adapter context menu info if you are using context menu, and you should this time instead of position you should get access to ID, because it is database type. Database has its own indexing system, it has its primary key relationship. That ID would be fetched rather than, because there is no array list, so we don't have a indexed for array list, because in this case there is no array list. So I need to depend on the primary key to handle transaction. So this is an example for simple cursor adapter. Let me see if I can add here. So, okay, I'll create a new project to explain another adapter that will slightly need some sort of explanation as well. Very close. Custom adapter example. It's my package name, it's unique. Next. Next. Finish. And one more suggestion, I want you to keep a Android perspective always instead of some other perspective like package and project, it will, chances are there you may edit some other file which is something having a dependency over your project which should not, you should not modify. So I would recommend always stay in a perspective called Android and keep these three folders alone visible, so that the chances of editing some sort of Gradle or system file would be limited. You won't touch it at all. So make sure you always be in the Android perspective if required. And I've noticed people are in a different perspective, like package and project. But if you are using, make sure you don't touch other file, system file. Mistakenly, if you edit or delete, you will have to recreate your project from the scratch. So better you'll always stay in this perspective. Need to create some layout again, need a list view. To make it simple, I'm going to write a very simple example. Stuff I really. I hope this part won't require much explanation. I just kept the default text on the top and below. I keep the list view. Let me see how things looks like. A simple list view we have, that let it be. I have no time to remove them. Let me go back to my activity. It's everything done for me. All I need to initialize my list view. This time I'm going to have some sort of different kind of array list, or my own customized data set which I want to display in my list view. For example, let me create my own custom data type, okay, student will do. Going to have a string. It could be anything, any kind of data set, to define what is student. A student class or student object is going to contain its name, roll number and subject. So I created my own customized data. I'm going to give access to this private data type using setter getter to, so that the public access can be given and can be edited. So it should be generate getter and setters. Okay. This one alone coming. Yeah. example. So I define my own customized object which defines the attributes or the behavior of a class called student. A student is an object which further contains certain attributes like a name, roll number and subject. This is my own customized data. I mean, it's my own object type. This case. Now you have a set of student record defined in such a way. Anyway, we need a subscripted value. So array list of student difference. I'll initialize here itself. Empty set. This is an array list of my customized data type called student. I mean, this array list is going to contain a set of students having their own roll number, subject, or name. So let me just hard code or create something dummy. In this case, just create a student object. Because I don't have any form, I'm just going to hard code. Because I don't want to spend much time with this. First set student name, any name. This is the first set of a student, so I just am adding the entire set to first entry I got added. Second entry I can reuse the same object, first clearing it, making it empty again and pass the different name. Add this also. So like that I'm going to create some records. It's the same. Whatever, I finally add this. So this array list, in my case, contain four students. We see how many? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. So this particular array list contain four students record, and each student have their unique name, roll number, subject. So I created my own customized data type. I defined their behaviors or their attributes, and so that those values can be assigned when you initialize the object, and that each set of object being added to this array list. So this is your customized, your unique data type. Can it display this data to array list? Or sorry, not array list, of course, adapter or list view, whatever. So this is your unique case. So we don't have a ready-made adapters for that. A simple cursor adapter did the job when I use a cursor data type. Or if in case array list, array adapter can be used. Or if you have array list of hash map, simple adapter can be used. But if you have your own unique data type, now you would have to create your own adapter also. There is no way. Okay. Let me create my own adapter now. It could be a separate class or it could be your inner glass, but I'm going to keep it separate so that I can reuse it if required. I'm going to name it as a student adapter because it's going to display something on the student style. Any name, it's a customized one. It should always extend to base adapter, because base adapter gives you a view holder inflation capability so that you can iterate over multiple times with the data, whatever you supply. It's having a lot of abstract methods, seems to be implement methods, all methods. There are 4 abstract methods present. I'm going to implement them all. We'll come back to them. Before that, we have to make our layout so that I can go ahead and inflate it. I think I can copy from the previous one directly instead of wasting time here. I'll copy from my previous source code. List box, something I used, I remember. I can copy it here. Okay. So this list view, I mean, I want to inflate this view. The example, the name is slightly bigger, so that's why. But this particular view, so here I may display student name, maybe roll number. The student subject can also be displayed if required, but we'll think about it later. Okay. I'll do one thing, I'll have that also. Maybe I'll define one values. The text is so bigger. This dummy value will be helpful how the layout looks like, placeholder. So just name it as a placeholder. Here one text, extreme, bottom one text, probably will display any space here, subject I can display on the top. Need to see how these things have been kept. I may need a help of a linear layout here. I want to keep it to the right. This top stuff, we are not going to need it. This is for roll number. Maybe I'll put the text, so subject on the top. Before I'll see how things look. Sorry. Let's give some sort of margin to look better. Enough, I think. probably some sort of spacing between the text. Okay, so here we are going to display the subject, and the bottom we are going to display the roll number, and this is for name, and we have plenty of space, so anyway the things could get adjusted accordingly. So this is having subject, roll number and name holder. So we're done with the layout. Now we go ahead and create our adapter first. Expand it. Okay, what is the count? How many data you want to display? I'm not sure, so I may need a constructor to tell what is the incoming data, so which I'm trying to display. So I'm going to need a constructor to inject the data to this class. There's going to be an array list of student. It's going to come. This is a local data type coming as an argument. I may need it as a global type. Remember, both is having a same name. It doesn't mean both are same. The one defined in this class called this.student is a global object, which is actually this one, and this particular one, which is coming through an argument, which is a local object. I'm just transferring this to here so that this object can be accessed by all the methods. If you don't want to put this keyword, you can have some sort of different name, so that name conflict won't appear. It's up to you. So you can use in this way. Otherwise, if the same name being used, make sure you put this, so to differentiate this particular object is a global one, this is a local one. So the count being size, how many data is going to come, that many data I'm going to display. Get specific item. So students dot get position, that particular record alone. For example, this will be helpful if the user tried to click on the list item, so that particular item alone can be retrieved. Right now I'm not going to use any database, so ID won't be helpful. So I'll give the index or the particular position itself as an ID. So I'm going to use this because I'm not using any database one. So these things have been modified so that this adapter is going to iterate a layout number of times of the size of the array. So 10 student record means 10 times it will repeat. Anytime the item gets clicked, I can get the item object using passing the index of the item, which is available by the click event, and I can get the object. If you really want an ID of the specific object, you can give an ID, but in this case ID and index going to be the same, so I just pointed the index itself as an ID, or you can even retrieve 0 or something, unless we are not going to use any database in this case. Here the tricky part comes. This is where your data is going to get mapped. Few things I need to do. I need to get a layout inflator. Do one thing. Remember, this is what actually your adapter is doing, but I'm just writing in detail. But whatever your simple adapter, array adapter, actually it was doing the same way what I'm writing. But those things been already done. But this time we have to create. So I need an instance of a layout inflator. This layout inflator can be initialized. I'll just keep the layout inflator part on the top. Layout inflators instance always available from the activity. I need an instance of an activity, nothing but the context. I'll also retrieve it from the context. That's the reason we have a context as always the first argument for all the adapters. Get system service, get access to a layout inflator service. Getting access to a layout inflator is not an easy job because the context has a reference to a service. That service gives access to a layout inflator so that a layout can be inflated on the top of another. I mean, adding a layout on the top of another layout itself is not an easy task. You need an instance of a layout inflator that is actually available in any given context, of course, especially in activity. The activity in turn have access to a layout inflator in system services, and it gets it from there and have your layout inflator object ready. That I need to do some technique. The convert view, that's where I'm going to convert the view. This is a parent, mean any layout where it is going to get added. So usually the parent may contain an instance of set content view, whatever on the top you're trying to add, and this is where you are going to add a new view. Usually this view will be null before adding the layout inflator because I yet to attach the design. So make sure it is null and initialize the convert view and make it as inflate from the third one I'm going to need. R.layout.simple.listbox is what I am going to inflate on the top. The root, actually the parent on the top, the parent on the top of a parent, this layout is going to be added. The last one, do you really want to merge it, attach to root? Actually, we don't want to attach it. If you attach it, what will happen? It will get part of your set content view itself. I mean, it is physically attaching to a relative layout. I think it's a relative layout, I remember, because relative layer list view we had. If I put attach to root to set to true, it will have a catastrophic effect because the parent is containing a relative layout, and any attempt to attach a layout to a relative layout, I will have enough trouble because relative layout, if I add it, I need to define position and all the stuff, which it's very difficult at this point because relative layout is kind of a frame. So I always prefer not to attach it with the parent, keep it just inflated, just keep it on the top, don't merge it. So I'm going to keep it fast. That's it. My view is ready. And in this case, the parent instance also not necessary, you can still call it null also. because I'm not going to attach it, but let me see if any error comes, we'll come and go back. Okay, now the convert view has a layout inflator on added on the top. And return the view. That's it. I had to attach the data here because the students. Let us get back the individual text views. Students, what all the name I kept, I don't know. Let me see. One is name holder. Okay, I'll make this as a holder. Name, subject, role. From the convert view, find view by ID, get name holder. Text view, role number. Final one being subject. So all views which is located inside the convert view initialized. Now time to attach it. Anyway, the convert view. Okay, time being, I'll have this if block removed. I'll let you know what is the necessary of this if block. First, let us achieve our adapter part, display the data, then think about it. Anyway, the convert view is going to be initialized using layout inflator, and then we are going to return. I'm going to add the name set text. Students.get the position. Being a integer, because roll number we kept it as an integer, I want to make sure it is string always. So I just, anything gets concatenated to a string becomes string. So an integer concatenated with a string becomes string. To make sure it is string always, I just concatenate with empty string. All values been added and the view has been returned from the inflated layout inflator. Now values been mapped, and this is your customized adapter. In fact, this is what all adapter is doing. It has its own inflator service, and that inflate, using that inflator, it maps the data. So array adapter was doing with the simple array list or array with the one layout, and simple adapter was doing with array list of hash map, and the third one cursor adapter was doing with the cursor data. In this case, it's my own data and my own adapter. But we are not, it's not perfect, but let me first test it. Time to attach this adapter. Student adapter, initialize it. first argument being context, second argument being the array list. That's it. Adapter is ready. So my adapter data now took it and it's the list is being populated using your customized adapter. So the view has been iterated over and data has been mapped to the specific views. Let me slightly make it much stable. I just want to display a lot of data, so let it be a duplicates one. Display much data as much as possible. Remember, it works fluidly. In fact, it will work fluidly because the data types are quite simpler. In such a case, if you'd like to display some images, the images tend to take some sort of memory. It may take some sort of memory because the images are getting iterated over and over. Apart from that, the adapter has one built-in concept called view holder. View holder, I already talked to you, the space given for your device to display the content. Adapter has a view holder. For example, your array list contain say some 200 data, set of data. In this case here itself, it contains a lot of data. When you try to attach an array list containing 200 set of data to a list view using an adapter, the adapter does not load all the data at one side. It loads the data which is the view holder is maximum can display. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Only 8 data has been added to a view holder. Rest of the data has actually been added as you scroll up and down. This is to conserve the memory, not to overload the adapter. And most of the adapters, simple adapter and cursor adapter, array adapter, having that capability. It means you can simply add as many as even millions of data, millions too much still, but say as thousands of data. It only displays or adds some 10 data or 15 data, which is what is your view holder size. The rest of the data it loads only when the user scrolls or scroll up or down. What is the view holder size, additional data being added on the go, you may not be even noticing it, but this will take a very lesser memory. It will load faster since the view holder size of data alone loaded, only 10 data is loaded, not the other data is being loaded. This is how all the adapters having loading the data. But our customized adapter does not do it because we had to add that particular concept because it's my own adapter. I haven't added that capability to my adapter. If you really want to add that capability also, you may have to do some sort of little tweaks. That also I will implement. But remember, this is optional if you really want. If you are thinking you are going to load a huge number of data, you can have this particular solution. Otherwise, you can simply leave it as it is. It is called view recycling. So I won't because I will simply use the existing view rather than creating a new view. For example, in every occurrences, remember this block gets repeated to the size of your array list. So if you have a 1000 times, in 1000 time it will iterate over. But if you are using view recycling, mean if the view is already created, don't recreate, simply use the existing view. So you can attach that concept of view holder to recycle your view instead of recreating every occurrences. That is what I'm going to attach that solution. For that, you are going to need a dummy class. Any name can be given, since it is something to do with the student, I just gave it. An inner class, remember. Declare your text views inside, whatever the text view name. Simply I move them to a special class, just a normal class, inner class. I move the declaration inside this class. Now, let me recycle the view. First, I am checking whether the convert view is empty. Then I will create. So for that to achieve, first I have to initialize student. Just declare the student view holder object. If the convert view is null, then here initialize the student view holder. From the student view holder, call them all because these objects have been moved. I'll come back to this guys. Keep it outside. Anyway, we have a student view holder object created as a common method here. I mean object here. Not initialized, I just keep it not to start them. If a view holder or convert view is already existing, recycled, because the convert view, one set of data which has already been created in the very first view holder cycle, which has already been created, I can get in such a way convert view set tag. Get back the convert view instant. Sorry, holder student holder instance. Need to have this resource. Couple of hooks. One, the convert view if it is empty. The view holder first time initialized because there is no view. And from that, you are calling the name, roll number, subject attributes being defined, or object defined inside, and you are initializing them. And your view holder has been initialized and have been attached to a convert view object itself. Set tag is a method where you can bind a generic object to a particular class. A set tag can be a number, can be a boolean, can be any object which you are going to need additional. So for example, you have a student attribute, a student data, suddenly you want to attach a student ID which you forgot to add. So using set tag, you can add additional bundles to width, I mean if at all the option is there, you can attach them. So for in this case, what I'm doing, I'm checking the convert view. If it is empty, I recreate the view holder and attach, reinitialize everything, attach it with the convert view itself. And in such a case, convert view is not empty. It will get back the view holder from the tag itself and attach the data. This will conserve very lesser memory, and this is what your view holder technique works. So this kind of adapter can load thousands of data without any problem, without any there won't be any kind of lagging or anything else. So this will immensely improve your performance of your adapter. Remember, array adapter or simple cursor adapter or simple adapter, everything is having the view holder mechanism added. So the same mechanism I have added here also, but this particular thing has certain issues as well. Even though it improves the performance really well, but sometimes it cannot retain the reference. For example, in your list view, if you are using checkboxes or radio buttons, which is going to have their own click listener, for example, button or a checkbox radio button, it will have their own event listeners. In that case, this convert view will terribly fail. It cannot retain the selection of your view so that it can receive the event listener. But in such a case, you don't use it. It's up to you to have this view holder mechanism in place. Otherwise, you can very easily do the same one which I just few minutes before I wrote. Directly initialize the convert view, get back all the text view and attach the data, finish your job, done. Or you can have this convert view or this particular view holder mechanism added to it. It's up to you. I would recommend having this view holder option added if your list view is going to have a composite data such as text view, images or something. But I won't recommend the same view holder if you are using buttons, checkboxes in your list view. This time it won't be helpful at all. So it's up to you. Anyway, I've added this also. Let me run it. So this way don't see any difference, but it will have some sort of better performance if you are using its convert. That's it. So this is your customized adapter, and you can all you need to create your own adapter with a different set of data type which you are expecting. In this case, it's array list of student object. If it is a different object like JSON array or maybe a linked list or whatever if you have in your mind, that can also be added and put into use with the list view. So layout inflation being done using a system service called layout inflator service. For that, the context instance needed, and I create the instance of layout inflator well before in the constructor stuff, and I inflate whenever needed on every occurrences of your array list. So this, the entire block seems to be called multiple time as the your size of your array list. So student size, if you give a different size number, it will, for example, in this case, if I am giving hard coded value like 5, only 5 set of data will be displayed. It won't display other data. So you need to maintain the same size of the data and the same can be displayed in the array list itself. So that's it. This is a simple, it's a customized adapter. So afternoon, you guys complete this example as well as whatever pending. Make sure you finish it off. Tomorrow we'll see, what is that? We'll go into a layout inflation in detail. That's where we are going to introduce fragmentation. So fragment concept. So we'll see that in tomorrow's session.